A second round of talks to resolve the long-pending Assam-Meghalaya border dispute concluded on a positive note a short while back. And Assam Chief Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma and his Meghalaya counterpart Kongrat Sangma today held crucial deliberations in Guwahati, wherein it was decided that both the states have agreed on resolving the dispute in 6 out of 12 identified areas of dispute. The 6 areas are Tarabari, Hahim, Boklapara, Gizan, Khanapara, Pilingkata and Ratachera. Meanwhile, both the states have also agreed to form regional committees to be headed by a cabinet minister. And Meghalaya Chief Minister Kongrat Sangma said that both the sides have agreed to focus on ethnicity, administrative convenience, sentiments and contiguity to resolve the matter. Kongrat Sangma also added that the regional committees would visit the areas of dispute and subsequently submit a report within 30 days.
The meeting was a very constructive, a very positive meeting that we had. We have been very clear from both the governments that we want to resolve the areas of differences and the disputes that are there between the two states. It has been very long, and a lot of people have suffered in different areas because of these differences that have existed. Therefore, there is a very strong political will to find an amicable solution to these areas of differences. Number two, we have also agreed that whatever we do, it must be done in a respectful manner, and both the states need to respect each other. Today in the meeting, we had a detailed presentation given by the government of Assam on 6 of the areas of the differences that are there out of 12. The strategy which both the state governments have agreed to follow is to take up these matters in a phase-wise manner. So there are areas which are slightly lesser complicated, some slightly more, and some very complicated. So therefore, we would like to resolve these issues by taking the disputes or the areas of differences in a phase-wise manner. Therefore, we have decided that 6 areas out of the 12, 1, Tarabari, 2, Gizang, 3, Hahim, 4, Boklapara, 5, Khanapara, Pilangkata, and 6, Ratachera. Out of these 12 areas of differences, these 6 areas is what we have decided that we will move towards finding an amicable solution to these. In the interest of ensuring that it's done in a much faster manner, we have also decided that there will be regional committees that will be formed by both the states, which will be headed by a cabinet minister. So we have 3 regions where these 6 areas of differences fall in. So in these 3 regions, we have 3 committees from Meghalaya and 3 committees from Assam, and both will be headed, or I should say both sides will be headed, each committee will be headed by 1 cabinet minister. And we have decided also that we will focus on number 1, historical facts, number 2, ethnicity, number 3, administrative convenience, number 4, willingness and the overall sense of the people's sentiments, and number 5, contiguity. Based on these 5 areas or these 5 terms, we will try to find a way forward, and we have urged these committees to submit their reports and their findings after making joint visits to the different areas and locations within the next 30 days. Within these 30 days, the Honorable Chief Minister of Assam and myself will also be making some visits to some of the areas of differences also, in order to give a positive message to the people and to show our keenness and willingness to move forward to finding a solution to this very, very important and long-pending difference and dispute that the two states have. So once again, I would like to thank the Honorable Chief Minister of Assam and the Government of Assam for having invited us for this meeting. And I'm very, very positive that with the right political will and with respect for each other, and ensuring that the realities of today's world are also taken into consideration, that we will be able to find a solution to these difficult problems that we're facing. Thank you very much.
Meanwhile, Assam Chief Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma also added that it was a positive start to begin the process by concentrating on six areas. Chief Minister Sarma also reiterated that a step-by-step approach is required to resolve the issue. Meanwhile, Chief Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma added that if differences exist, the matter will be taken up at the chief ministerial level. And apart from this, Chief Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma assured that both the sides are committed to resolve even the most complex aspect of the interstate border issue.
As has been indicated, we have 12 areas of dispute. Of course, from Assam side, we don't have any dispute. But dispute has arisen because government of Meghalaya has claimed certain territory in these 12 locations. When we met in Shillong, we decided that all these 12 disputes cannot be resolved at a time. So we have to take a step-by-step approach. In the last meeting held in Shillong, government of Meghalaya had given a presentation flagging their perspective on the issues. Today, government of Assam has given a presentation highlighting our point of view. Basically, after threadbare discussion, both in Shillong and Guwahati, we found that it will be good if we start with six locations. Honorable Chief Minister of Meghalaya has already indicated what are those six locations. From Assam side, these are in Kachar district, Kamrup Metro, and Kamrup district. From Meghalaya side, it is in West Khasi Hills, Rivoy, and East Jayantia Hills. So what we have done, for these three districts, we have taken the name of Meghalaya for the purpose of reference. So for there will be a regional committee which will be headed by a cabinet minister from Meghalaya side, which will be headed by a cabinet minister from Assam side, and the three regional committees will be there to resolve dispute which are there for West Khasi Hills, Rivoy, and East Jayantia Hills. Now, this committee will also include bureaucrats and maybe the local representative. We have decided that from both sides, committee will be constituted with 5 members. Now, it is up to the government of Meghalaya to notify that 5 names, and of course from Assam side we will also notify the 5 names. These 10 people who will be nominated by each of the government will in turn visit the sites, interact with the civil society, Gaon Bura, Panchayat members, teachers, and other civil society members. They will complete their discussion within a period of 30 days. Because as after the presentation from both sides, we realize that this may not be a very, very complex matter.
All right, and more, you are being joined live with my colleague Joydeep Hazarika, who is right there outside the venue. Joydeep, the second round of talks to resolve the long-pending border issue, concluded on a very positive note. So, Joydeep, what are the major highlights of today's very crucial meet? You are right there during the meeting and during the press conference, Joydeep.
Yes, Priya, I was actually there in the press conference, the joint press statement which that was given a short while back. Today, definitely, it is clear that the move to reach to a conclusion to the vexed interstate border issue between Assam and Meghalaya has moved forward in the right direction. Today, perhaps the biggest highlight that should be taken forward is that now both the governments will go forward to resolving certain disputed side in phased manners. Right now, what has been decided and what we have gathered from the joint statement is that both the states have identified 6 particular disputed sites. As per from what Assam CM Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma said, these particular 6 sites are in the not complicated category. According to him, these are certain sites that can be resolved in a fast and amicable manner. So under such a scenario, the Meghalaya and Assam government will form state committees for each disputed site. And from each side of the from both the states, there will be 2 committees from each state for those particular disputed sites. The committees will consist of 5 members and will be headed by 1 cabinet minister. These committees will go to the particular disputed sites for which they have been formed. They will go there, they will take stock of the ground scenario, interact with the locals and the village headman and all the local people. They will take stock of the ground scenario and they will prepare a report. This exercise will go on for the next 30 days and in between, both the CMs of Meghalaya and Assam will visit a particular disputed site of Lampai. They will go to Lampai. It is not specified when they will be going to Lampai to take stock of the ground scenario, but both Himanta Biswa Sarma and Conrad Kongal Sangma will be going to Lampai together. They will take stock of the scenario just to show the people that both the chief ministers of both the states are quite serious in reaching to a conclusion to this border dispute. Now, obviously, once all of these, this exercise of committees going to 6 disputed sites are carried out for the next 30 days, after that, there will be a meeting again, either in Shillong or in Guwahati, that is yet to be decided. And once, and in that meeting, the reports from these various committees will be submitted, and then they will be scrutinized as to what next should be done. And following this, there will be another phase where 6 more localities will be identified, and then further committees will be formed to assess their ground scenario. Now, it is being expected that in the second phase, the localities which will be identified will not be some not complicated areas, but this will be mildly complicated areas. But that is for a later part. For now, for the next 30 days, the 6 localities are being identified from Assam side. They are in Kachar, Kamrup Rural and Kamrup Metro. And from the Meghalaya side, they are in Ribhoi, East Jayantia Hills and East Khasi Hills. So these particular sites, they will be visited by these particular committees and they will take stock of the scenario. In a way, it is a very good move. Today's discussion has moved in a very positive direction. Now with this phased assessment of the disputed sites, it can be hoped that by next year this issue will be pretty much solved on a large basis. Yes, there are certain disputed areas which fall under the very complicated category. They may take some time to resolve, but I was there in the press conference. I asked Meghalaya CM Conrad Sangma if his government is eager to get this border dispute problem solved before Meghalaya completes 50 years of statehood next year. He said that would be a very ideal situation. He said they would love to achieve that milestone, but he also said that these things take time, so they will have to wait and watch how things unfold. Apart from that, he was also quite positive about the way things are moving forward, and his assumption and what he told us during the press conference was that the give and take policy is something new that has been taken by both the Assam and the Meghalaya state governments, which is why they want to give it a try, and they are hopeful that this will give them that this will give both the states good dividends and good results.